welcome to another episode of A Few Minutes with Marvin. I inspire those who aspire to make positive changes in their lives. And today I want to talk about truth, right? And it's not a comfortable topic for some people because, let's face it, a lot of us don't like telling the truth. The phrase, "the truth will set you free," is such an accurate quote. And I know it sounds cliche, you know, a lot of us don't believe that speaking the truth means anything, right? It's become something that people don't do anymore, right? They like to keep things hidden, or they like to hide behind the facts, you know, and then not present themselves in a truthful way. Why do you believe that is? I don't talk a lot about energies in my videos, but I do work with energies quite a bit. And if you're on your spiritual path, you know what I'm talking about. You know, we are energy. I've said that in all of my videos. And, you know, there's the chakras. There's seven chakras. There's actually many more than that, but seven are the main chakras, and they're all energy. So the energies around now, I'm talking about June of 2022 right now. It's the energy of magic, right? And there's a lot of opportunities for those of us who are willing to put in the work to bring those opportunities and to receive those opportunities into our now space. It's a very manifesting time right now, June of 2022. So why is the truth so important now? Why will the truth set you free? Because, again, energy being what it is, the energy of having a false life or telling, you know, not telling the truth all the time, being fake, wearing that mask, right? Not the actual physical mask that they were trying to make us wear during the pandemic, but the actual, you know, mask. You know, who are you when you're around certain people? You're one way with one person, and you're a different way with somebody else. That's a mask. That's not the truth, right? What these energies are calling us to do now is to start telling our truths. And yeah, some of those truths are those deep, dark secrets that nobody knows about. Those things that you do when nobody's looking, right? Or those thoughts that you have when nobody else is around. It's time for you to identify those and release those things. If you're having any negative thoughts, or if you are a habitual liar, or you skirt around the truth a lot, right? Whether it be not to hurt anybody else's feelings or not to have anybody judge you for your truth and your beliefs, regardless of what that is, if you're a person who just gotten into the habit of skirting around the truth more than you actually say the truth, right now it's time for you to start identifying those things and then to really start speaking them. And you're like, hell no, I'm not gonna tell anybody about this or that, you know. But the more you start telling your truths, the quicker you're gonna start manifesting what these energies right now are trying to bring to you. If you're feeling that, oh my God, why does this thing keep coming up? And I have to lie about it some more to cover it up, to keep covering it up, to cover up, to cover up. The cover up is gonna get you in the end, right? So it's gonna behoove you to start addressing those things, especially those things that are coming up for you. I've had some issues recently that are from my past, you know, that I really thought I was done with. You know, that was the old Marvin, you know, that was in my past. I don't think that way anymore. I don't do those things anymore. But recently, they've been coming back up. You know, I have some new situations in my life, and the old ego started coming back and going, oh, wow, you know, we can trick this person into this or to believing we're this or we're that. So recently I've had to deal with my truth and go, no, that's not my truth anymore. But it's not enough for me to say, no, go away. I don't act like that anymore. I don't talk like that anymore. No, that's not enough. In order for me to unblock myself or to stop blocking myself from the manifestation that I so want to come in, I've had to own my truth. And I've literally had to go to a person and say, hey, look, in my past, I would have done this, this, and that when this situation occurred. And it's occurring with us now. And I'm letting you know that I was thinking that. And in my past, I would have acted on that. But that's not my truth anymore. So now I'm speaking my truth, not for your sake, but for my own sake, for me to shift that situation so that it never comes back again. Because obviously there was something there that was keeping me in it. And obviously I fell back into it really quickly. So as spiritual as I think I am, something came back in that I thought I would never think about or act on ever again. And I did it. This time I caught myself and I go, no. You know, my ego's like, oh, you're never gonna tell that person that you did that. I was like, well, guess what? I am, and I did, and it's so freeing, you know. And I didn't even give consideration to whether that person was going to judge me, whether I was going to lose a relationship with that person. Yeah, those thoughts came in. That's why my ego wanted to stay in control, saying, there's no way you're going to do that. And I did. And guess what? A little later on, that person spoke a truth to me. And energetically, we freed ourselves from that, right? So I know going forward, anything else that comes up that was true about me in my past, that's no longer true, but if it comes up and there's an opportunity for my ego to step back in and take control, I'm gonna stop it right in its tracks. And it doesn't matter what the situation is. If there's somebody there that I need to speak and act on my truth with, I'm going to do it and not worry about the consequences of that, because the consequences of me not speaking my truth are far worse than the consequences of me giving in and lying, because energetically it's going to stop me from manifesting my dream life, whatever it is I'm trying to manifest, which I'm trying to manifest some things. So I encourage you to do the same. And if it's not easy, or you're having resistance to speaking your truth about what you do or how you do it, or judging somebody else, whatever it is, I'm going to challenge you to stop yourself and not just set it aside and go, okay, you know, I'm not going to do it. I would have done it in my past, but that's not me anymore. You know why? Because that's spiritual ego. When you think that you have something under control and it keeps popping up, just because you're spiritual doesn't mean that you have it under control, and doesn't mean that it's not going to affect you in a negative way somewhere down the road. So right now the energies are saying, if something's coming up for you, that's something that you thought you left behind, that you healed, you know, we're always doing that shadow work, right? I healed that. Well, sometimes if it's still lingering, it's not healed. And it's always a truth that needs to be told, even if you're telling it to yourself. But sometimes you got to speak it out loud to somebody that you trust, right? So that it no longer energetically holds you back. Because not speaking your truth gives your ego full control. And even if you've killed your ego, or you think you killed your ego, lying or half-truths or sweeping something under the rug always gives it an opportunity to come back in full throttle. You won't even know it's there, and one day you'll go, wow, I started doing that again. When did that happen? You gave your ego an opportunity somewhere by not speaking your truth on it. So it's you know, you have to hold yourself accountable. So are you ready to hold yourself accountable for things that are energetically holding you back in your life. It's time to stop with the ego and put it to bed or put it in time out, but this time not for just a couple of years, for the rest of your life. And the only way to make that happen is by speaking your truth. And it's gonna hurt some people, and you're gonna lose some friendships over it, family members. But in the long run, those people are only meant to be in your life temporarily anyway. And it's not about being cold or callous, but these energies that are around now are asking us to be true to ourselves and not to worry about what other people think, how they're gonna perceive me, whether I'm gonna be judged, or any of the consequences that might come from it, because the truth always sets you free. And as long as you speak your truth, only good things will happen. You have to believe that. And you have to take ownership of it and accountability for it and let it go. And that's the only way it's gonna, you know, move you forward and allow you to receive everything that you want. So start manifesting today by speaking your truth and not worrying about being judged about it, losing people over it. Because if you lose anybody over speaking your truth, then those people were energetically holding you back anyway. And to some degree, you were holding them back. So it's time for us to all free ourselves, because only we can free ourselves. Nobody else can do it for us. So speak your truth today and free yourself from the bonds of the ego. And have an amazing day. Does your ego get in the best of you? Are you constantly trying to shift the energies around you, but you don't know what's holding you back, and you're afraid to speak your truth? I can help you with that. I am a spiritually based transformational life coach. The link to my website is down below. Please hit me up for a free 30-minute decompression session. And if you like the contents of this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with friends and family, leave a comment, and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. I'm truly grateful. I always speak my truth. Start speaking your truth today and free yourself. Thank you for spending a few minutes with me.